this third Sunday of Easter is a day that reminds us of our Christian mission of making the face of the risen Lord shine. The risen Lord too came to his apostles and made his face shine on them. And as he makes his face shine on them, he is breaking open many realities. As we have heard in the Gospel for today, after the disciples from Emmaus arrived in the upper room and were telling what had happened to them on the way, and as they had recognized him in the breaking of bread, Jesus himself stepped in. And when he steps in, he comes in to break more realities open. All along the way on the road to Emmaus, Christ was breaking the word of God to them and led them to the breaking of bread. And as they were breaking the news to their brothers in the upper room, Christ again breaks in. Grace breaks in to reveal more realities about the resurrection. And this is how he makes his face shine on those who are his friends, to break open many more realities and outcomes of the resurrection. When he comes to them and reveals himself to them, he is also at the same time coming to break the silence about the resurrection. As the apostles were listening to their friends from Emmaus, they were a little bit startled and amazed, and some were fearful. It's a mixture of many feelings. And this fear is not the fear of fright when one is in danger. This fear is of awe. Coming to realize slowly by slowly that their master is alive. They had never experienced such a thing before. I think many things were kicking in around the words he had told them. And when he comes in, at the conclusion of the Gospel, he reminds them of what he had told them before. So he comes in to make his face shine on them so that he can break the silence about his resurrection. He also comes in to break open and to break through their unsettledness and troubledness. That's why he gives them the gift of peace, to be at peace within themselves, to be at peace with one another, and to be at peace in the world. When he comes again, according to the Gospel for today, he comes to break through their disbelief. And this is why he tells them, he's giving them a narrative about himself. You see, I have a body, do not think I'm a ghost. And immediately he asks them to give him something to eat and things of the like. In these words, the Gospel writer is telling us that the reality of the resurrection of the Lord took place and took time for the apostles to understand it. The Lord came and they could not immediately recognize him. That's why he explains to them that, see, I am the very one who was with you. It was difficult to identify him. This does not mean Christ had changed. He was the same one, the one they had touched before, the one they had eaten with before, the one they had listened to before. But because he had entered in the full glory of his Father, a few aspects of him had changed. So the difference between the Christ they touched and the glorified one was what Christ was making clear to them. So he brings clarity. And when he speaks, clarity about his resurrection breaks in to be the answer to their troubledness and unsettledness. Again, when our Lord comes, he breaks through the many questions that they had in their hearts. And when he comes in, he steps in to break the detachment that was there between them and him. That's why he says, come and touch me, see me. He is reconnecting them. And when he comes, he breaks through the ignorance of scriptures that the apostles harbored up to that day. And when ignorance of scriptures is broken through, we see Peter in the first reading preaching very eloquently about the risen Lord he had understood to be in the full glory of the Father. That through him, the act of healing the crippled man happened. So as Peter is speaking, he's convincing his audience about the resurrection of the Lord, by breaking ignorance of scriptures. And when he breaks the ignorance of scriptures, he also sends them to be witnesses of the things as the Lord had told them, that you are witnesses to these things. Peter too is also encouraging and inviting his audience to become witnesses. We are the generation of witnesses. We have not seen the Lord physically, but in faith we meet him. And as we saw last Sunday, this is a higher faith. And because of our faith, we are sent to make the face of the risen Lord shine on all people. By the way we assist those in need, by the way we accompany those in sorrow, by providing solutions to hunger, by curing the sick, defending and standing for the defenseless, caring for those who are neglected, protecting and giving assurance to the abused, and speaking for the voiceless. If we do all these, we are breaking the silence about mankind, and we are revealing the face of Christ risen to the world. And this is what makes us truly the children of God. We pray God helps us that by the new supply of his graces, we may be rooted in him ever more firmly and be vibrant and strong witnesses to this special calling, which leads us to be breakers of the mercies and compassion of the Lord. The Lord be with you.